guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 10 of season 2 of Layback Camp. So let's go ahead and get started in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, it's so pretty. Hi, guys. Nah. Yes. I kind of wish Sakura was going with them. I mean, because, like, best girl with another best girl once again. Because, like, Rin's already, like, what, there already? Because, I mean, she left early in the morning. How she could be there by now. Okay, so who's thinking that Kirby's gonna be the first one to fall asleep? I know I am. Told you! Because, of course, when you stay up all night, when you can't sleep because you're too excited, you know, the trip on the way to the excitement, 50 out of 50, you are going to fall asleep. Rin probably just chilling the whole entire time.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, that's what happens when you are the first one there. Poor Kirby. She can't even see it because she knocked out. Oh, Jesus, she's just asleep. That girl is gone. Mm-hmm. And so still, you might still make it before them. Oh, it's a shrimp that looks more like a lobster. Wasabi and ice cream? Oh, like sweet and spicy. Yeah. Kirby. So pretty. It's complicated. Hey, you could sleep. Take a nap. Yeah, that is a big anchor. Yeah, Curb, wake up. Well, guys, the episode is over. Kirby? Check your phone. Oh, that looks so good. Yeah, you missed so much, Curb. It's honestly so nice to see them all together again. Because, yeah, the last time we all saw them was Christmas. And it just, in a weird way, it feels like it's the last episode. Oh. But it's not. Ah, yes. Alcohol. I can't imagine, like, going 25 days without drinking alcohol. Well, yeah, I've done it before. I barely even drink alcohol now. Like, I drink it on, like, occasions. And I don't even drink, like, hard liquor. I drink, wine. If you're of age, you know what I mean. If you're not, it's just gibberish to you right now. Okay, well, why don't you split? Oh, of course. Anna is just very good at telling everybody everything. But she still is also good at keeping secrets. Well, you guys could just go camp somewhere else. That pose. You'll find it. Yeah, she's right. Let's not talk about that. Nice thinking, Rin. Ah, yeah, for the birthday. I don't know. No, but it's okay. At least you still get to see it, you know? Jesus. All that energy. Okay. So, how'd you do? God, that's beautiful. So messed up. It's so funny though. Oh my god, this poor child. Aggie. Oh my god, honey. Oh, you poor baby. We all knew it was gonna happen, so that's why I'm not really that surprised, but still. And she was like, yeah, you know, I worked for a year, done my job, like, I got this. No.
Oh, Jesus Christ, what the fuck?
I can't. But, you know what, hey, maybe at least she tried. She tried. Third place ain't bad. It's not first, it's not second, it's just third. Honestly, this was cute. I loved seeing everybody, and I mean truly everybody, having also Aoi's little sister, like, join. It just, it's cute, and it makes it even more adorable, and I love it so fucking much. Like, Jesus Christ, like, they're just so adorable. No. Of course, the sisters would be the end card. Something tells me... Okay, so we are now very, very close to the end of this. I think the show at least has, like, 3 more weeks before it's done. I want to say 11. All of 11 will be them, you know, doing their camping. And 12 will be them on their way home. And then, who knows, maybe Nadeshko's friends might make another appearance by the final episode, because, I mean, it would make the most sense. Even though her character is more of a supporting role in this second season, while being more than, like, a main character, because I really thought that introducing her into the show as someone who has not read the manga, but... really loves the loves the craft and supports the crap out of the voice actress who plays Nadeshko's best friend way, way, way before she met Rin and everyone else. I was expecting her to always be with the girls and almost be in every single episode, but because of the fact is she lives somewhere completely different, I get the fact that they can't have every single episode of her being featured and such. So the only time you really just get to see her is the opening credits, which does suck after a while, because, you know, when you are anticipating a character, they finally come, and, you know, you want a little bit more, and you're expecting a lot out of this, like, anime company, how probably the manga, when it's still currently being, you know, written as of now, and you want to see, like, just cute moments with all these adorable characters, and you don't get that, yeah, it's a little upsetting. But I do like the fact that, you know, like I said, Aoi's younger sister is with them and is traveling with them, because it's just so, it's just adorable. And you get the feels of the final episode of season one, and I'll never forget that day, because when this show officially ended for season one, I was, like, I was devastated because it felt really weird after this show ended. And it's kind of almost like that when any show really ends, but when it's a show that you really take close to your heart and you love and care for, like you're nurturing a plant, a baby, and this is kind of weird for me to say, but when you almost like put your all into that show, like your entire being into that show, you, the supporting, the buying merch of it, buying the DVDs or the whole entire Blu-ray when it comes out and such, because I don't think this series has a Blu-ray here in the West. We all know it has it in Japan, but I don't think it has it over here in America and a couple other places, and I kind of hope that it does, because this is such a really good series that I think any family should be able to watch and such, whether they're in, whether their kid, well, really, not only, because I know all kids like animes, of course, including my age, because I'm a woman. It's something that people who have never truly seen anime before can sit down and enjoy. I feel like my mom would enjoy this series. My mom really don't give a crap about camping, but she would really enjoy it, I think, for the funny laughs and everything, you know, just as much as I have and anyone else has, because it's a sweet, cute comfort series that everyone loves oh so much. But I honestly cannot wait to see how next week goes and how fun it's going to be for them celebrating, you know, Kirby and, you know, Aoi's birthday together and, you know, eating good, some good food. Like, oh my god, that's, whatever they about to cook, it's going to be good and I can't wait. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episode 10 of season 2 of Layback Camp. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like, really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel, I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad, and of course, I will see you guys officially all next Thursday for episode 11. Bye, guys! We'll be right back.